we have faced the ravages of COVID and of police violence while living in constant divisive political rhetoric. Despite all of this, I've heard so many stories about teamwork and grit and self-sacrifice at Montgomery College that I can't even begin to count them anymore.
The beneficiaries are the workers who will get jobs, the county, of course, in having people at work, and the companies that will have a trained workforce. And of course, Montgomery College is proud to be able to provide the training.
I think this is the opportunity, maybe of the lifetime that I've been doing all of this work and bringing my experience to have these courageous conversations with our communities.
Look at the situation that we're in America right now with 2.3 million people in prison and ask yourself, how safe do you feel?
Have an election coming up, and we, I think, have the opportunity to let the government know what kind of immigration policies we would prefer.
Look, we get it. 2020 has thrown a lot our way, but voting is something you can do.
Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. But there ain't nothing gonna stop me now, 'cause I'm almost there.
I want to congratulate Montgomery College President Dr. Darion Pollard on her new role as the next president of Nevada State College. Dr. Pollard announced last week she'd be stepping down as president of Montgomery College.
I'm extremely grateful that I had the privilege of leading this phenomenal institution and to work and live in a community like Montgomery County. Montgomery College will always hold a special place in my heart, and I'm forever grateful for the relationships that I've made, the lessons that I've learned, and the mission that we got to advance. And it has been a glorious experience. I will remain a forever fan of Montgomery College.
I can see already just how great this experience will be, and that we will ensure, we, the whole of Montgomery College, will ensure that the institution moves to the next permanent president in a way in which you would have expected, and that we will respect that as we think about you and, again, the legacy that you've left here in the state of Maryland.
I expect you all to take great care of Dr. Dukes, as well as you've taken such great care of me for the last 11 years.